It's called the Golan Heights. And on the other side of the valley, you see a mountain range as well?
Parallel to that, corresponds to this one.
It's called the Naphtali Mountains. The top of the mountain range over there, the other side, makes up the Israel-Lebanon border. The watershed level about is the Israel-Lebanon border. And over there, somewhere at the edge of the valley, is Israel-Lebanon border as well. So the Israel-Lebanon border makes a kind of a north to south to north extension, and then ends up somewhere there. The snow-capped mountains there are already in Lebanon, and villages as well already in Lebanon. So this stretch of Israel that we are driving in now basically is a panhandle. It's called the Panhandle of the Galilee because it's a panhandle between Lebanon to the west and what used to be Syria until 1967, what used to be Syria over here to the east.
All here used to be Syria.
This part of the Jordan River here that we are traveling on now was formerly, here was a lake and a swamp until 1950, about 1958. There was a swamp here and a lake which was drained during the 1950s by digging many canals, a complex system of canals along and across the valley, canaling it to the Jordan River. And the parts of the Jordan River here that you see that were formerly the swamp and the lake was artificially created. That's why it's a kind of a straight line, very neat straight line. To the south of the bridge where we entered here to the Jordan River, it's the natural course of the Jordan. It was until 1967, made up the Israel-Syria border, the Jordan River. Here, the Israel-Syria border until 67 was the shore of the lakes, about where you see the eucalyptus trees over there. About there, that was the Israel-Syria border. I tell you a bit of why Israel took this area of the Golan Heights, and the run-up to the 1967 war was quite a chain of events that the war started in 1948. You know, the Arab-Israeli War in 1948. Israel was created in the middle of a great war with its a great showdown with its Arab neighbors in 1948. And the end of the war here in the Syrian frontier ended up in a reality whereby the Syrian army managed to conquer and hold some territories in here in the Galilee, a stretches of few kilometers here and there, and several strips. And the armistice terms signed at the end of the war that concluded the war in 1949 kind of basically stated that the Syrian army would withdraw from those stretches of territory, and they would be declared a demilitarized zone. They will go back over the international border, and the areas which they stayed in the Galilee, which they managed to capture, they were unable to go any further, will be declared a demilitarized zone. And over this concept of a demilitarized zone, or rather the interpretation of the Israel's sovereignty, degree of sovereignty over this demilitarized zone, there followed many clashes. It was a kind of a very particular flashing point, which was a cause of constant violence here in this Syrian army here in the Golan Heights on the slope, and driving here. So it was a kind of a cause of constant exchange of fire. The people here living in the area, the kibbutzes, many kibbutzes,
these are temporary bridges that in case Syria blows out the real bridges, they push these over the Jordan River. These are the jeeps that we were on. There's Max, smiling. We had an interesting jeep ride.
We have the sovereignty, but it's demilitarized, so we don't allow to introduce the military. So the conflict over this interpretation of the agreement, this was one flashing point. Another one was the water resources, utilization of water resources. This again led to many clashes. The Arabs claimed, maybe perhaps rightly to some degree, that Israel is utilizing too much of the Jordan River, pumping it too much. And so they tried to disturb by violence, and they tried in the early 1960s to divert the sources of the Jordan River farther north in Syria and farther south to the south of the Sea of Galilee. And Israel, of course, could not accept that because the Jordan River is the bloodline of his country. So he had to use the army to stop their projects, and this again led to many border clashes. Many skirmishes, which was a real hell for the people here. Kids were regularly going in bomb shelters, and farmers working in the fields were a kind of on and off, shot at and targeted, and so it was really helpful for the people here. So when the 1967 Six Days War broke out, initially it broke out as a war between Israel and Egypt only in the south, the war on the ground. Israel was at the early stage of the war, at the first days of the war, was intent on completely destroying the Egyptian army, which was the most dangerous, the biggest of the most dangerous of all Arab armies, which are kind of pledged to wipe out Israel and all that. And he did it quite successfully at the beginning of the war. And here the Syrian in the Golan Heights, they just founded the kibbutzes here. They, earlier in the war, they started to, they kind of tried, but failed to invade the northern part of the Galilee, around Kibbutz Dan, but they were not able to advance. So they reverted just to bomb the kibbutzes here and the settlements. And the people here living here, they could not accept that. They turned to the